Hey and welcome to Ahrefs monthly product updates. We have two tool updates and three general updates to share today. Let's start with our general dashboard updates because we have a huge initiative up first. Introducing Portfolios, our new view that lets you track and monitor a custom list of domains and URLs. Adding a portfolio lets you group a list of URLs from up to 10 domains and see their aggregated metrics in some Site Explorer reports. Once saved, the portfolio will always be shown on your dashboard along with top-level metrics, just like projects. Click on any metric to open the corresponding report in Site Explorer. One great way to use portfolios is to track your own portfolio of sites or URLs. For example, in this portfolio, I'm tracking all of Wired domains. You can also use it for competitive intelligence. For example, to see the top winners and losers in terms of their top pages and keywords, add your competitors' websites to a portfolio and go to the top pages report, then add a traffic improved filter. Moving on, you can now see competitor metrics on your dashboard. Just click on Show Competitors at the bottom of any project widget in your dashboard to expand the list of competitors added to the project. The metrics and deltas in bold exceed the values of the main target. Moving on, dashboard folders are available on all new paid plans. You can now create folders and organize your projects, portfolios, and keyword lists. Moving on to Site Explorer. First up, we've added a new standalone page inspect report that shows you the change history of a page's HTML code, which can also be viewed as plain text. Its main use case is to compare changes made to a page at two points in time. For example, this page on our blog was published a while ago, but barely got any traffic. Then all of a sudden, around mid-August, organic traffic saw a big spike. Let's go to the Page Inspect tool and compare two versions of the content. One from around September 1st, and the other near the beginning of August. Now, if we hit the Page Text button, we'll see that there was a full content update on this post to better match search intent. And it clearly worked. Next, in Overview 2.0, we've added a new widget that shows you how your target's referring domains and backlinks are distributed by top-level domains, or TLDs. To see just country code TLDs, toggle this filter on. Click on the map or the table below to filter referring domains by TLD. Moving on to Site Audit. First, Site Audit now supports structured data validation against 190 mandatory rules listed in Google's guidelines. We've also added a corresponding Site Audit issue, along with a filter to toggle between schema and Google issues. Next up, there's a new hreflang link graph in Site Audit that helps you visualize hreflang issues. Now when you inspect a page and click on hreflangs, you'll see the whole hreflang cluster of a page. Errors with pages and links are highlighted in red, which lets you quickly spot which link is missing, or was added by mistake. The table below shows more details on the connections. Moving on. You can now filter by changes in fields, either by numbers or by percentages. This opens up a bunch of use cases. For example, we can now look at the Ahrefs blog and page explorer and add an advanced filter for pages that saw an organic traffic decrease of at least 10%. Other things you can filter for includes pages with changes in word count, indexable pages that became non-indexable, pages whose titles or meta descriptions changed, and redirects of modified target URLs. And that's all for today. If you have any feature requests, you can leave them on our Kenny. See you in the next update and have a great day.